Okay, this is the way our handle has come down. You see it's still got the same basic shape I showed you earlier. And we have got, let's see, where's my orientation? Okay. That's the way it's going to look. And I got it down to about a medium sanding on it, so it's going to have to go to the fine sanding. And this is still on a rough sanding. I'm going to sand this down to a medium. And then do my drawing on it. And then carve it out. So that's where it's at for right now. Okay, now, what I've done is I've drawn out my design on the stem, and in this case, it's some vines going up, and twisting around. In this case, I only did two, and then I drew out a heart shape to be the shape of my grape leaves. And then I'll go back and do the detail on them. Now what I'm going to do is I'm using a V-gouge to go along the outside of the vine mark. Now, right now, all we're worried about is getting that outline in. I'm not worried about removing the background or anything yet. Once again, you just take off just little bits. Shallow. You always go back and make it deeper. All we want right now is just the outline. And where your vines cross, you'll determine whether you want it to weave in and under and over and all that. So that's gonna, when you carve it, the one that's going under, you'll have it sloping down and then sloping back up under the one. It's kind of hard to explain. It's all a matter of fooling the eye. Taking a two-dimensional surface and making it three-dimensional. Kind of like a drawing. Can't get in there with the V-gouge. I don't have any micros. These minis aren't the best quality. I mean, they're good, but not like you got a $200 set of micro carvers, you know? So you use what you got. But that's the basic idea. And then because I've got so much detail on this cane, it's going to take me a while to do it, as far as the carving goes. You can do it a lot faster with one of them Dremel tools, but there's certain things you just can't do with a Dremel. Well, that's basically how you get started on it. And like I say, you just be careful, take your time. I love wood carving. Plus, I keep switching back and forth between the different Z gouges. And skews. It just depends on the area I'm working in. Then what will happen is once I get it carved and the background removed to give it that three-dimensional flavor, what I'll do is I'll take a wood-burning tool and highlight my outlines. I'm not sure how detailed I'm going to get on the leaves or not. I was thinking the other day maybe I'll take the leaves and maybe burn the veins into it, but I don't know. I haven't quite decided all of that yet. To remove the background, I'm more than likely going to use the Dremel tool, just because it'll probably be faster. We'll see how it goes. See, that's the way it's going. You can see how I'm working on the vines right now. I just did one little stem of a leaf. But that's the way it's going. And I'll do that right on up. And then just keep working on it. Come back after I get the vines done and work on the leaves. This is supposed to represent a wild grapevine. So, that's how it's going to go. It's going to take a while. But, it's alright.